Hi. You ask a question whether people are intelligent or wise, and pat the answer will come back to you stating that they are all wise. Second thought, intelligent. No, I'll choose to be intelligent and wise both. Let me tell you that intelligent people, they are very, very sure. But people who are wise, they are always a little confused. So they harness the knowledge and information, education always to their benefit. That's the reason they stand up. They are always capable of achieving or getting things done and excel in so-called life. Intelligent people. They have tricks up their sleeves when faced with situations. So they are always kind of very, very, very kind of, you know, jugadu. They may be resourceful and very skilled. That's the reason they are called as jugadu, right? Very, very resourceful and skilled also. They know where to get what from and which is the right place to get what from. Likewise, you know, they have answers to many a concern and queries. Of course, there are people considered intelligent who might not have all of these attributes, you know, maybe like scientists, but they are still intelligent. But the wise one, you'd always figure out that they actually lack that kind of a confidence. So my basic question is, intelligence have invented the basic concrete, today what we call as the concrete durable roads, which have been paved in many of the cities, and it's been laid down in many a cities called as smart cities. Typical example that I would like to give you is the city called as Chandigarh, the most organized city, is now facing a problem. For a couple of years, they are facing a problem of waterlogging. What Mumbai has faced and what to a three-tier city like Nagpur would be facing surely. So everywhere there is a development of this concrete replacing the tar road. It's a sign of intelligence, agree. Very durable way of laying down roads to create durable structure. I mean, sustainable infrastructure we all talk about, we have seen it. There was nothing like this before. The tar roads could not sustain, but concrete would go through many weather cycles. Intelligence and wise. In the movie Three Idiots, in a college setting, the dean of the college fails a student for his inability to complete the project in time. The student pleaded that he was not himself because his father died. An emotional trauma getting into him, this child, this student, and he was not able to complete the project in time. The dean responded that his son died and he still was present to give lecture the very next day. An intelligent person would say every person should be tough, while it takes wisdom to understand not everyone is alike, and that's how the nature keeps balance. Car was invented basically to move faster. But when we see cities like Mumbai or Gurgaon, the fastest car actually competes with the bullock cart at the most peakest time of traffic hours. Almost runs on an average speed less than a bullock cart. Are car engines not that good anymore? So a wise person would be mindful, would think and apply his understanding and knowledge with experience. Not always his experience, but the experience of others as well. He would not mind questioning himself at every step of the way or rethink if what he is doing or he did was good, bad, wrong, right. A wise person would not boast about his achievements. His ability to question sets him apart from an intelligent, and that also keeps him humble. Certain examples of wise characters would be Master Yoda in Star Wars or Professor Dumbledore in Harry Potter. In real life, I know many people more than them. Again, intelligence and wisdom are traits. An intelligent person can be stupid at times, while a wise person might be unwise. These qualities are there for us to grab. Unfortunately, the world today just focuses on being intelligent for every being and not wisdom. This is what creating all sorts of problems, according to me. If you take few examples of intelligence and wisdom, to my kitty, I think intelligence leads to arguments. Just because you have a most polarized, knowledgeable mind, and wisdom leads to settlement. So Even if you are indulging in some kind of an argument, there are people wiser who would like to settle down rather than make or prove their own point. Intelligence is power of will. The power of will that you exercise on road, free will to jump signals, right? And wisdom is power over will. That means you need to control your attitude when you are alone. Possibly when you have set of rules to follow and you are conscious being. Now, intelligence is heat, it burns. Wisdom is warmth, it comforts. Getting out of control while driving and suddenly you see someone crossing by and you put a brake and your vehicle makes a screeching sound and then suddenly you stop there, look back and grind to that person. Heat burns, but see at the other one. Once try this, show that warmth in case if you want to exercise your wisdom power. Right, let him go. You also take a control, right? It will definitely comfort. Intelligence is pursuit of knowledge. I said this. It tires the seeker. As long as you want, you would still say that I have not occupied in even a corner of a square. Whereas wisdom is pursuit of truth. It inspires the seeker that unending path of reaching resilience, trying to approach excellence. Ranjor Das Ji. Intelligence is holding on, staying power. Wisdom is letting go. Grudges, fights, ego, fall. Intelligence leads you towards so many paths, brilliant paths, right? But wisdom guides you. See a typical case of a politician or a spiritual leader, right? An intelligent man thinks he knows everything. Sab aata hai. A wise man knows that there is still something to learn. An intelligent man always tries to prove his point. I'm right, well read, I know of it, I have come across. But a wise man knows there's really no point in arguing. Just make a point in case if you have, otherwise keep quiet. Patthar se sar phodoge to khoon hi niklega. An intelligent man freely gives unsolicited advice. A wise man keeps his counsel until all options are considered. Intelligence, wise. An intelligent man understands what is being said. Tumhe pata hai, tum kya keh rahe ho? But a wise man understands what is left unsaid. An intelligent man speaks when he has to say something. When you have to say something, you speak out. Sign of intelligence. But a wise man speaks when he has something to say. Only then he opens his mouth. An intelligent man sees everything as relative. Sub relative. A wise man sees everything as relative. Aur dukh mein bhi kahin na kahin khushi ko jod leta hai. So wise man is an evolved lot, a conscious lot. An intelligent man tries to control the mass flow. An intelligent man tries to control the mass flow, whereas the wise man navigates the mass flow. An intelligent man preaches a lot. He'd like to say to all, the wiser man will be keeping quiet. Just reach out many. Right? So intelligence is good, but wisdom achieves better results. I just have to say is, we all want to be wiser. We are intelligent lot because we are living in the most dynamic world, the dynamic society here today. But to be wiser, we need to have a lot of mindfulness. And what is that mindfulness? It is nothing but showing a lot of emotions towards others. And if you have that kind of an emotional inclination shown towards each other, I'm very sure there will be a gate open to mindfulness. And this mindfulness will definitely have a lot of human angles to a lot of creativity and innovations that are happening around. I would not say that an engineer should stop working towards making of concrete. I would not say that cancer drugs should not come. I would say only one thing is, think of humans first. The creativity or innovation has to fall in place with only human angle, only for the betterment of human society at large. Keep this in mind. Maybe ponder more.